Yes, today we discuss about another lesson, right? Lesson 5, it is create and apply style capabilities in CorelDRAW, right? The text style effect and color style effect. So capabilities, you can able to do this kind of text and color style effects, right? So first let us check. First for text we apply the color styles. Suppose here you draw, you type otherwise design, design. Right? Then you can make it bigger and give some color, make it bold also, right? Here I am giving red color. So I am duplicating this because I want the same kind of different same text in different shapes, right? So I am duplicating. How to duplicate? The plus. Applying plus, right? So this is, and again duplicate these two. On keyboard press plus, right? These are the same fonts, right? The four fonts, same fonts I am using here, right? Here I want to use my page is in landscape, right? So because I want width, more width, right? You can select this, now keep this inside. So what we do with this? Suppose I am duplicating this by pressing plus on keyboard. Here I want to use Enolab. See, by pressing this Enolab, here we have some presets, the preset effects, right? So rectangular and a freehand kind of things are there, right? So presets, I am using circular. So your text is getting into circular, and this is rectilinear, and this rectilinear slant, right? And it is pinch, push down, push up. So I am applying control Z to getting back. Control Z done, keyboard, right? So these are the presets, right? When you click on this Enolab, change the shape of an object by applying and dragging the nodes of an Enolab. So those are the default presets are available, but here I want to use for my own shapes. I want to convert text within my own shape, that I want to do, right? For that, so I am using control plus on keyboard. So control F7 on keyboard, press control on keyboard and use F7, right? So again, control F7, right? On keyboard. See, these are here, the envelopes are there. So here, add new or add preset, right? Suppose here, so when you add preset here, there are different kind of presets are there. See, when you click on that, it is ready to apply on that. Suppose here apply, so it is changing the text into that particular shape, right? And control Z, click on the selection tool, this pick tool, and control Z, right? So these are the presets are available. So whatever the presets you use, suppose this, and you say apply. Yes, it is applied, right? And again on pick tool and control Z. So these are the add presets are there, right? So apart from this, I use different presets. So because I want to use, so more different presets are there, right? And verticals are there, right? Suppose this apply. So within that star, the text is changed, right? So again control Z to come back. And here what I am planning, so I want to add my own preset, right? Own shape. So with that I am planning, see, this is my box. First I want to take one rectangle. This is, so here I want to add one shape tool. Right, suppose here there are the options are there here. So control Z. So instead of that, I want to give my own shape, like with the pen tool I'm preparing this. Yeah, suppose this is right. And this is one. And one more shape I want to create. Right? And this with shape tool. Right? So we select these nodes and paths, edges. The nodes and edges I can select here, right? Suppose this is one more thing, and here I want to draw another one. Suppose this is right. Yeah, this is a different one. And here I'm planning a one more, yes. And again here it is, yeah. These are my different shapes I'm giving, right? Then here what I'm doing, select that one text, right? And here with this create from, you select that and click here, right? And then immediately apply this, so it is automatically applying to that. See, apart from your your own presets, you are creating your own, right? So according to your given shape, it is changing, right? The same way again, here I'll use one more. So after selecting that, take this create from eyedropper tool and click within this. See, that path is applied here, right? And say apply. So it is applied. Yeah, you both are same. So I want to use another one. Suppose this I want here. This I want here. Because it's already two times it is applied, right? Yes. Now again. So I'm applying here. Right, it is applied there. Yeah, keep there. And here I'm selecting one more thing and select your text and choose create from and apply here, and see the path is already designed around the text, and say apply, right? So this is. And again, you select this another one, right? And say okay, apply. Say text is applied. So the text is not readable here, because your shape is like that, right? So that is the reason you have to give that a proper shape. That is very important. So if you don't give that path properly, so you won't get the actual the readability of the text. Okay, so again here there is one more shape here, so I want to apply here. Right, see, this is. So after adding this, you can edit that. Suppose with shape tool, click on the shape tool and there are nodes, and suppose here your text, you can give adjustments by selecting your handlers. You can change accordingly your text. So this is what are the styles, text styles, right? So in this we use textile effect, right? The another one is color style effect. So what is that color style effect? Again, I'm taking new. Right, so color style effects means here just you can create something, anything, like one shape. Yeah, otherwise easily I'll create one thing. There is a box, right? Press on keyboard. Right, so that means what? It is duplicated. See, this is your design, right? And again, give one more plus on keyboard, and you turn this. See, we are creating one more duplicate of that. Exactly right, and here. Select everything. So that means all shapes by pressing shift. I'm selecting everything and control G. So grouped everything, right? And duplicate again. So that means I'm applying plus on keyboard. And turn this and make smaller. Make smaller, right? So this is, so this and this you can duplicate by pressing shift, right? Yeah, it's not duplicated. So this and this, right? So Control G, so duplicated, I mean combine this one, grouped. Control G is for group, right? Perfect. So next, so after applying a group, what we do, I want to fill colors. So I don't want the single color, I want to fill different colors, right? So I'm using smart fill tool. There is a color window is there, fill color. So here I'm using these colors, right? See there, and here I'm taking this color, and again right here I use the same colors again. So here I want to use a red, green, blue, and again a red and green. And blue. Okay. So I use few different colors, like something like so, because here I'm not using that proper colors, because it will take time, unnecessarily wasting of time. So instead of that, I'm planning to use some colors, right? Yes. So again, I'm taking these light colors. So for timing, fill whatever the color you want, right? Yes. Now here I'm using suppose yellow. Okay. Can select everything, right? Control G. So that is grouped everything. Now here see, I'm duplicating this again, plus take this here. Now what we do here, I want to add color style effects, right? For that so go to window, from there dockers are there, from color styles already here, that is already there, color styles. So again you click there, you will find dockers and color styles. See here, two options are there, drag here to add color style, drag here to add color style, right? Drag here to add color style and generate a harmony, right? Right. Suppose here yeah, I'm duplicating this again. So because right, I'm duplicating a plus on keyboard and drag this side. So if you observe here, so I'm dragging this and adding here, right? See here, these are the things are opened. So that means here the colors, how many colors are there inside, those many colors are added here, right? So from there you can see there are show color viewers are there. Suppose here show color palettes are there, right? So here show color sliders, right? So from that, suppose here check in any color, right? Just move this, check in any color, and suppose with this eyedropper tool you can apply here, so anywhere here, right? So it is changing to that, right? And suppose here take this green, right? Can use this color, see, only the green is changing. So that means what, at a time you can change your colors. Now I want to apply on blue, right? This blue, and with eyedropper tool instead of blue I'm using some white, see, the white, or otherwise yellow. Control Z with eyedropper tool you have to choose, all right? So yellow. So in this way you can add the color styles also, right? So one more thing, so here after adding this, what you do, you can delete all these things. Use this dustbin to delete all these styles. So what is the use of this? Suppose at a time in the same color, suppose the yellow areas are there, at a time you can change your yellow portions by selecting this yellow, and you can choose with your eyedropper tool and choose color, and automatically that particular color will change. So present I'm deleting all these things, right? Next this one, so drag here to add color style and generate a harmony. Suppose here, see, I added here, the harmony is generated. So that means what, here the how many colors are there, so 1 2 3 4 5 colors, right? If you want to add 7, save okay. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and say okay, right? So those are the colors added here, see that, those are the colors added. And suppose here just click here, right? Click here, the harmony effects are there, right? yes, right. Then select any color and choose this and change to another one, right. Here it is changing. The same way here, there are harmony editor is there, so right, the harmony editor, you can see this harmony editor. So yeah, I want to click here. So here you have harmony editor. See, by moving this, the entire that portion, the color portions are changing, because you are there here, right? So that group, drag color styles onto the folder icon to group them in a color harmony. So with that group, we are changing into that, right? And suppose here I'm using harmony folder, right, and dragging color, suppose here, right. See this. So you can enlarge this, the same color giving more darker, right. And suppose here you go back, it is giving that light intensity, right. So by adding and moving this, the harmony, you will get a more different colors, right. So now just click here, so only that color, right. See here, you observe here, it is changing. Just go back, that light, that intensity, that the brightness is reducing here, and you can move forward adding more dark. And suppose see here, I'm changing. So this color harmony will give you the more control on overall your design. So it is already dividing into 7 boxes, right. So groups, suppose this is a harmony folder and this is harmony folder, these are all folders, though, or otherwise individually also you can, by individually also you can control on that, right. So this is very helpful. So these are the things we discussed today, right. Suppose here, yes, we discussed this today in lesson 5. We created and applied capabilities of the style effects, right. So for textile effect and color style effect. So you also can practice this, then you will understand, right. Just you can follow this lesson as it is. Thank you.